Okay, so boom, this is a brow tutorial. This is what I'm using. I'm using just a brush to brush your brows up. Anastasia Beverly Hills, the Duo Brow Powder. Yep, that. I'm using a brow brush, an angled brow brush, any brow brush of your choice. I can't talk, but whatever. Some brow gel, not even gonna use that one. So right now, I'm just about to brush my brows up as much as possible with my spoolie. And you can use any spoolie. I'm using one from an old brow pencil. Just doing that. Girl, hurry up. What you doing? And again, that was the Anastasia Brow Powder Duo in chocolate. I feel like chocolate is like the perfect color for me because it's not too light and it's not too dark. And if you like natural brows like me, then that is the go-to. Right now, I am just filling it out, shaping them underneath it first. So I'm just following my brow bone with the angled brow brush. That's what I'm doing. That's what it looked like. Yep, so I'm just filling it in here with the powder, and then I'm going in my actual brow with the brush as well. Yo, I need to cut this. This shit gotta go. This shit too long. And then I'm going back in with my spoolie and I am just blending in the powder into my brows by brushing it upwards just like we did in the beginning. So I'm going up and then I'm sweeping it over to shape my brows. So that brow's done. And I'm gonna go ahead and do the other side. Oh, I lied. Okay. So right now, I'm just using the lighter part of the duo. And I'm going in the front to do that faded effect. And then I'm pretty sure I'm going to blend that again afterwards. See, this is why it takes so damn long to get ready. I ain't realize I'd be doing all this. Now that brow's done. Okay, so boom. We gonna move on. Go to the next brow, you know what I'm saying? I'm a little uncomfortable here. Arms long, head too big, and I can't see. So, you know, that combination kind of messes up trying to record doing your brows. So I'm doing the same thing. I'm going in at the bottom. Just shaping it. I would call it outlining the brow first. And to me, one always turns out better than the other. I think the other one looks better, but whatever. Just gonna go in, fill it in with the powder, following my brow shape and all that good stuff. Whoops. Alrighty, I'm back. Uncomfortable again. And as you can see, I'm using light motions with my brow brush. I'm not drawing on my brows. Like, I'm not drawing with that powder. And I'm not putting a lot of pressure onto my brush because if I do that, then they'll just look like Sharpie brows. And some of y'all like that, but that's not my thing. So I went in and I brushed my brows up again using my spoolie. And now I'm just tweaking it, wiping off any excess powder that I have on my brows. So I'm still filling them in. Like I said, this brow is always different from the other one. So if your brows don't come out perfectly the same, that is perfectly normal. Usually people have two different brow shapes, so you have to cater to each individual brow shape and just try to make it look, you know, as similar as possible. But you can always clean up with the concealer, which is what I'm going to do anyway. So yeah. And if you're anything like me, I'm a brow perfectionist. You can take way less time to do this. It's just I have issues and I'm a perfectionist. So I take 15 minutes to do my damn eyebrows. That's OD. Alrighty, so we're doing the same thing. Just basically blending those brows in with that spoolie. Going in with the light part. It's two different powders, as y'all saw in the beginning. So I'm using the light powder in the front again. And then I'm going to blend that out with the spoolie as well. And a tip to avoid to your eyebrows looking a lot different. If you go ahead and get your eyebrows waxed, I do not. I haven't got my eyebrows waxed in years. But I actually pluck my eyebrows with tweezers. So if you actually clean up your brows first, the better the shape. Do not go to a makeup artist with your brows undone. Oh, I'm doing something. So I'm using the Ruby Kisses in medium concealer to conceal under my brows right now. But yeah, like I said, do not go to your MUA with some jacked up brows. That is wrong, y'all. Get your brows done first. So I'm going underneath my brows with my concealer to clean up any excess powder underneath the brow to make that shape pop. And no, I'm not using a porcelain white concealer under my brows, because that white line under your brows is the fuck ridiculous. And I don't know who told y'all to do that, but it's not cute. So I'm going in with a concealer that looks a little bit similar to my skin tone, or a little bit similar to the foundation I would use. So it has a yellow undertone to it. Although in this video, I didn't do my foundation. I usually do, so. Yeah, but for the sake of this video, I was just on brow, so. Taking that underneath my brow, and then I'm going to blend it in. And usually I don't do the top of my brows, but in this video I did. And that was just to try to get my brows to look similar again, because I'm a perfectionist. Because ain't nobody got time to be doing all that on the regular. The regular. All right, here go my dirty beauty blender. You can buy a cheap one from Ulta Real Techniques, but that's the actual beauty blender. $20. Every 3 months, you're supposed to change the sponge. They got me bent. I don't do that. You can wash your beauty blenders with dish detergent or baby soap, and you'll be just fine. I actually use my beauty blender until my beauty blender tells me to throw it in the trash can. That's my personal opinion. Don't listen to me. Change your beauty blender out every 3 months. Okay, so boom, here I go. This the end, for real, for real. I'm blending my brows again just to make them look perfect. And I actually use the Essence Brow Gel instead of the NYX Brow Gel. So this is still brow gel, but this is just colored brow gel. It's in brown. You can buy this at Ulta. I really like it because it keeps my my oils. Well, yeah, it keeps my oils controlled, because I'm an oily person. So if you're oily, you know what? Just forget it. If your brows get oily throughout the day, use a brow gel to keep them in place and to mattify your brow hairs. That's what I'm trying to say. Girl, my parents started talking to me in the video. They didn't know I was recording. This is pretty much the end of the video, though, now.